Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I'm back from the Data Analyst Bootcamp that was held last week in Frisco, Texas. I want to thank everyone who came out to that bootcamp. We had a great time with 40 people. I have lots of new questions and also some great tips to share with you over the next week or so. Also, last Thursday, podcast number 500. I want to thank everyone who entered that contest. By the time this podcast airs, I will have chosen the winners. You can go to podcast500.html at MrExcel.com. To see the winners, I'll be sending emails out and allow people to choose their prizes from among the 40 great prizes we had donated from Q and Holy Macro Books. The other thing that we had is last Monday, I think it was, episode 497, someone wrote in with a question about how they could search for a substring. And I went through this big, long, convoluted solution. And I love the podcast audience because when I say something that's wrong, boy, I hear about it. I got phone calls. I got emails. Everyone's saying, hey, Bill, there's a much better way to do that. So I appreciate everyone who wrote in. Basically, what I had done was I said that if we wanted to look through column B and find any cells that have A, B, C, I basically wrote this formula that says, look through that column and see if you find the value A, B, C. Now, I mentioned that that will return a number if it's found. For example, if it's found in the fourth position, it'll return the number 4. Or an error, and so we had to use the isError function and then the not function, and it was really a big, long, convoluted hassle. It turns out that the countIf function will allow you to use wildcards. So we don't need to add the extra column, we don't need to do any of that. Just say we want to countIf all the cells from B6 to B27, and then we're looking for star ABC star, that's all in quotes. And sure enough, it goes through and finds anything that contains ABC. So even if it has A, ABC, D, it will find it as a result. The other cool feature here that someone pointed out is that this also works with the autofilter. If we would turn on data, filter, autofilter, we get the autofilter dropdowns, and rather than being able to use one of the built-in choices, we would go to custom and say we want to look for something that contains ABC, click OK, and we'll get just the ABC records from the group. So there you go. Using either the contains or the wildcard option in CountIf, a much better way to look for a substring within a column of text. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.